the River Avon, flowing through Stratford upon Avon, home of the bard William Shakespeare. Few names in all of British literature are as well known as that of William Shakespeare, and this town was his home. This is the theater of the Royal Shakespeare Company. It's currently closed. They're not performing any plays here right now. It's undergoing a major renovation. This is the birthplace of William Shakespeare in Stratford upon Avon. Scholars are relatively sure that Shakespeare was born in this house. This is Shakespeare's birthplace from the other side of the house. What would have been more or less Shakespeare's backyard? Well, of course, British don't use that term. This is the grammar school where scholars assume Shakespeare would have attended school when he was a boy in Stratford-upon-Avon. This is Anne Hathaway's cottage. Anne Hathaway was the local girl that Shakespeare married. She was several months pregnant when they married and soon gave birth to their children. She grew up in this small cottage. It's on the outskirts of Stratford-upon-Avon, Shakespeare's hometown. It's a very beautiful thatched roof cottage with a typical English garden in front. And as you can see, it's very popular with tourists. This is a statue of Shakespeare that sits in the gardens in front of the Shakespeare Memorial Theater. At the base of the statue are individual statues of four of Shakespeare's most famous characters. This is Falstaff, from the Henry IV plays and the Merry Wives of Windsor, one of Shakespeare's most famous comic characters. Here is Lady Macbeth lamenting that all of the water in the ocean will not wash the blood from her little hands. Here is Hamlet pondering life and death after he's found the skull of his friend Yorick. And here is young Prince Hal, who becomes King Henry V. In the Henry IV plays, he's still the prince, Prince Hal, trying to decide if he wants to be the playboy prince or the royal heir to the throne. This statue portrays Hal in the scene in which he, thinking his father is dying, tries on the crown. This is the Nash House in Stratford-upon-Avon. It was the home of one of Shakespeare's daughters and her family. Right next door is an area known as New Place. Now it's just a garden. But this is where Shakespeare, after completing his career as a playwright and actor in London, retired and built a home back in his hometown of Stratford-upon-Avon. In what was probably one of the historically not so wise decisions, the man who owned New Place in the mid-18th century decided he was tired of all of those tourists stopping and gawking at his house to see where Shakespeare had lived and tore it down. That's why this area where the house stood is now a garden. This is Holy Trinity Church. Shakespeare is buried in Holy Trinity Church. He's buried in Holy Trinity Church, next to his wife, Anne. The stone over his grave is inscribed with the famous curse: "Good friend, for Jesus' sake forbear to dig the dust and close it here. Blessed be the man that spares these stones, and cursed be he that moves my bones." This is a first edition King James Bible from 1611. There's little factual evidence about Shakespeare's life. Here in the church are records of his baptism, his marriage, the births of his children, and his burial. Other than that, much of what we read about his life is speculation. On display here in the church are the entries of his baptism and his burial in the parish records.